Welcome to the second day of action at the 2016 Slate Music Granite Open, live from the Granite Club in Toronto. We've got a great game for you this evening between Noran El Torki and Millie Tomlinson, both of which came through into this match with 3-1 wins in the first round. Torki beating Wagamans 3-1. Millie Tomlinson beating the qualifier from Finland, Emilia Sauni, 3-1. Should be a close game between these two, the 6th and 4th seed. I'm David Roper, and again, as I say, we're broadcasting live from the Granite Club in Toronto, for the Slate Music Granite Open, sponsored kindly by Slate Music, along with many other sponsors that we'll be talking about throughout the show tonight. The players just going off court, grabbing a drink, ready for the start of the match. Decent crowd there tonight. Still early in the evening. You expect that to grow over the course of the evening with the quarterfinals in action. Both these players pretty young, quite early in their careers. Highest world rankings for Torki at 54. Highest for Tomlinson at 39. Not a lot of separation between these players. We'll come down to who has the better quality on the day. Both didn't seem to show many nerves yesterday, and I doubt today will be any different. That's Torki in the pink shirt and Tomlinson in the navy. Both players will be looking to make a good start. Don't want to grab an early lead. Put pressure on the other.
Ready? Love off.
And getting their action under the way. Torki to serve. Loose from Tomlinson, punished by Torki.
One love.
Nice drive down the back end side. Good pace early on from both players. Oh, and that's a fantastic drop. She'll be happy she gets one of those in early on. Sign of the things to come. Another fantastic drop on that forehand side. Tomlinson's stuck behind. She'll look to push forwards now. Take a let. Safety let there. Oh, she's having a lot of joy early on with that forehand drop. Tomlinson stranded at the back of the court. She'll have to work to correct that. She'll push forwards. Thank you. It's a great recovery. She's doing well to move El Torque to the back here, Tomlinson. She doesn't want to let her have space at the front of the court.
Slap.
And she'll get a let. She's not happy. She wants a stroke.
Right side, four love.
Tomlinson looking a lot more settled in this game now. She'll call let on that.
Four love.
Just catching the foot there. It's an excellent replay. See, Tomlinson has got control of the tee now. Oh, but that was just too tight.
Five love.
Not a lot she can do there. Great shot from El Torque down the forehand drive side. Tomlinson getting some points on the board. She'll look to close the gap quickly. Referee for today's game is Thomas King. And he seems to be getting things spot on so far. Not too many decisions to make. That's a great drive. Punishing forehand drive from El Torque there. If you're watching at home, drop us a comment on the YouTube stream and let us know where you're watching from. Let us know if you have any questions you want to ask the players after the game, and we'll try and grab them and put your questions to them. Oh, it's an unfortunate boast. She's frustrated with herself there.
Hand out, 2-6.
Tight drive.
3-6.
Oh, it's a great pickup. Nice post to finish. Crowd appreciate that one.
And out, 7-3.
Tomlinson stranded behind her. Makes
seven,
the court
three.
Advantage count. Tried to take that one too tight.
4-7.
Tomlinson will look to capitalize on that mistake. Try and shift the momentum in the game. With the point every rally scoring, games can really change in a matter of seconds. Few points your way and you're back on top.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a fantastic drop. She held that well, sold the drive.
5-7.
Got it short into the front of the court. Oh, and El Torquay's saying she wasn't ready. Maybe we've got time for a replay of that drop.
5-7.
Players competing for the same space there. Could have gone for a let, but he opted to play through the interference. Oh. She'll probably only get a let there.
Play a let.
Yep, the marker gives a let. She was after the stroke, but she really can't complain too much there. She is complaining, but she shouldn't be complaining there. That's only ever going to be given a let. Pretty generous let of that as well. Should have played that. Tomlinson doing well to grind her way back into this game. Oh, that's a cheeky shot at the front of the court. Nice 6-7. Inside post. Squash shots we love to hate. Just push that down. She'll be frustrated. She's worked so hard to get back into this game. Both players getting a bit nervous towards the end of this match. End of this game, sorry. Oh. Frustration from El Torquay there. She just tins off the serve. Oh, she has after a let there. She's been given a let. Just like I was saying earlier, Tomlinson's dragged herself back into this game. It can change very quickly. And I don't think she'll be too hard on herself for going down early on. It happens in squash. She'll be pleased with the way she's recovered and she'll bring that into the rest of the match.
Not up, down, down.
Yeah.
9-8.
She's up 9-8 now. She's got a real opportunity to steal this game from under El Torquay's nose. See how the Egyptian responds. She will not want to let this game go. Oh, but that is a fantastic, fantastic nick there from Tomlinson. Great form. She'll get a let for that. A little bit of interference. You can see our title sponsor in the top left-hand corner, Slate Music. Everyone at the Granite Club is really appreciative of their support in this tournament. Oh, and that is a great nick.
9-10, game ball.
Lovely, lovely drop shot from the Egyptian. No chance. She'll be disappointed. She played for the interference twice. She loses the first game 11-9, and we said this game could turn. Two very close players. She'll have to start calling for more of those lets in the second game. And we'll be back with the second game in around 90 seconds. Welcome back. Close game of squash there between Tomlinson and Altorki. Altorki looked to respond in this second game. Called a few more of those lets. You can see both these players have had four game matches.
15 seconds.
They'll be looking to close this one off. Especially Tomlinson should be looking to get a three love win here. I don't think Altorki will let it be that easy. The fourth and fifth seed here, showing why they are the fourth and fifth seed. Close game of squash, high quality squash on offer. Both players incredibly fit. Start the second game. Tomlinson to serve. Tomlinson in the navy, Torquay in the pink. And she'll take a let for that. I expect both players this game to call a lot more of those. They won't be playing through interference. They both suffered from that in the first game. Starting off nice and tight down this back end side. Oh, that's a great sell from Altorki there.
One love.
Bit of trickery. Get a let there. She should get a let.
One love.
Yep, ref's given that as a let. Safety let. can see El Torquey's not playing through that interference this game. She'll take the let. She'll stretch this out as long as possible.
Stroke.
Oh, she's been given a stroke there.
Two love.
Rightly so. No way she could play that ball. Thomason will be frustrated. Tomlinson has an unusually high starting position on receiving that serve. I think she's trying to stop the ball coming into the back of the court. She's playing very high up, trying to get ahead of the Egyptian. She's complaining about the interference, but El Torquey's got every right to ask for a let there. Should be given the let. Let's see what the ref gives. Oh, maybe he's not going to give it.
Just play on, please.
Oh, he has. He has given the let. He's given the let there, rightly so. Thomason have to work very hard here to keep on the front of the court.
No
let. Oh, and she's not giving a let there. She'll be frustrated. That's a bit of the reaction to the let calls from El Torquey. Trying to get in on the action there. Disrupt play, but no let. Oh, and she's hit that down.
4-2.
All these breakages in play seem to be getting to Thomason a bit, but she's a strong player. She'll come straight back. We saw her do it in the first game. And you have to say that she's probably likely to do it in this second game. That's down. El Torquey looks very frustrated at that boast.
Hand out, 3-4.
Difficult shot to play. That's a great drop shot.
4-0.
And for your recreational players watching, you know that the boast tends to be quite a defensive shot. When you watch these pros women play, it can be a very offensive weapon. Difficult transition to make in your game, and these ladies have mastered that. Oh, she's frustrated she's missed that.
5-4.
High pressure game this.
Out.
It's out of court.
And 5-all.
5-5 in the second game. Very close between these two players. Great reaction drop there. Oh, and the trickle boast at the front. Unfortunate hit in the tin.
Yeah, left side, 6-5.
Again, if you're watching from home and you want to ask some questions to these players after this match, drop us a message in the comments section on YouTube and we'll put your questions to the players. Oh, and she's after a let there. She shouldn't get a let for that. No let.
Sorry, I can't.
That's given us a no-let. She's got plenty of room to play that. She's got to play that ball.
You guys have to play through it. I'm being fair to both of you. I've told you a couple times.
And she's arguing with the ref. I don't think he's going to take much of that. But that definitely was a no-let. We don't like to see too many lets and unnecessary lets and strokes in squash. We like to see continuous action. And the ref's trying to keep play flowing. She should get a stroke for that.
7-6. 7-6.
Get a let for that. She's frustrated, but she should get a let for this. What is the ref giving?
7-6.
Yeah, he's played a let. Seems like she was after a stroke. That's a let every day. This frustration and stoppages in play will suit Tomlinson. She'll use this. She's been a lot more physical on court in this game. Really frustrating El Torquey. Oh, and she should get a stroke for that. Let's see what the ref's given.
8-6.
Yep, the ref's given a stroke.
You hit the ball to yourself. It was a foot off.
Oh, and El Torquey's not happy with that call.
It wasn't to my set.
That's how I saw it. 8-6.
Can be a very frustrating game, squash. I'm sure after the match should apologise to the marker for those comments. Tomlinson has control in this game. She'll be happy with the way that she's responded to that early run of points from Torquey in the first match. That's a great recovery from a tight drive. Very aggressive game from both these players. Oh, that's a great drop, great recovery. She's having to work hard. Oh, and she's hit that down. Intense rally there, half foot squash. Both these players will be hurting. She'll be frustrated with that. She's having to take that early. Tomlinson's grinding harder on the court. Taking control of the tee. She's forcing those shots.
Out.
Yeah, that sounded down to me. Oh no. Ball out of the court. And Tomlinson takes a 2-love lead in this match. She'll be very pleased with the performance so far. Some top quality squash from both those players. Some frustration at the referee. But I don't think he's made any bad calls. Most of those calls were exactly what I would have given. I'm sure most squash players would agree with me. But it can be very frustrating, difficult to see when you're on court. And Torquey will hope to respond and try and win this one in five. But Tomlinson looking in control and looking like she's well on the way to a 3-0 win and progression into the next round. We'll be back in around a minute or so with the third game.
Yes, and then like you're going on the TV.
And you join us in the third game between Tomlinson and El Torquey. Close fought game of squash for those first two games. 11-9, 11-7 to Tomlinson. She's looking in control. She's pushing high on the court. She's made some changes in her game after going down early in the first. And she's starting to frustrate El Torquey now. A lot of interference seen in this match. A lot more than we saw yesterday. I think you'll see that a lot more progressing through the tournament as it gets closer and closer to those semi-finals and finals. These players having more at stake. They'll call a lot more strokes. They'll get closer together. They'll be a lot more aggressive on court. Referee doing well to keep control of this match. He's made some good calls. And he's not letting the intensity and passion of the players sway his decisions. Gets the action back underway. Tomlinson to serve in the navy blue. Torquey to receive in the pink. England versus Egypt.
Hand out, one up.
She's come out into this third game, all cylinders firing. Oh, pushing a little bit too hard there.
And it went off.
Tomlinson will look to just settle into this game and use that desire and aggression of Torquey against her. It's a great cross-court shot. Just a little flat on her feet there from El Torquey. Can happen when you're fired up to bring yourself back into the match. You do get a bit static.
Out.
Oh, that's out of the court.
Two off.
If you're back home watching, you want to ask questions to the players, drop it on the comment stream, and we'll put them to players after this match. That's a great, great boast. Just dying into the front. Tomlinson going ahead now in this game. She's been behind at the start of the other game, so she's really starting to assert her dominance on court. Torquey working hard to take back control. She's trying to get a let. I don't think she'll get that. She's complaining, but can be frustrating when you know you're a quick player on the court. You know yourself that you can get that, but it's not obvious to the marker, and he has to give her no let.
five.
Come on, Millie.
Should play that shot. She's been given the let. She's really trying to break up play with those let calls. But I don't think it will frustrate Tomlinson too much.
Hand out 6-3.
A lot of physical contact in this game. I'm sure they might be having words afterwards. Most of these girls are friends on tour. And I emphasize most. A bit of a fiery competition between these two. I'm sure they will probably share a drink after this match. It's war on the court. And best friends off. As always in squash. Great shot into the back of the court. And she's 7-3 up.
7-3.
But just as we saw El Torque take a 7-3 lead in the first game. And Tomlinson dragged it back to win. Anything's possible in squash. Get a let for that.
Hand out 4-7.
Oh, she's been given a stroke.
4-7.
It's a close one. Tomlinson will be a bit frustrated with that call. Oh. Straight back. I'm sure many of you playing will feel when your opponent tins the ball straight away after a difficult stroke let decision, it's a bit of karma coming into play.
9-4.
She's been given a no let there. The ref starting to put his foot down on some of these calls. He really wants to see a fluid game. We've got a question from Rowan on the stream asking what is a let and what is a stroke. So Rowan, a let tends to be when there's some impedance in play. Still possible to play the shot, but it might not be safe to do so. A stroke would be if there's severe infraction on the opponent's shot, such that the shot cannot be played. A very technical explanation there. I mean, in layman's terms, basically, if you interfere with your player's shot and it's not too drastic, you'll get a let. If it really stops them playing and they had an opportunity to hit a clear ball, you'll get a stroke. And you see Tomlinson wins that one in three. El Torque really faded towards the end of the game. But it was a good game of squash, and I'm sure El Torque will take a lot from this match and hope to carry those improvements forward into the next tournament. But Tomlinson will progress to the next round, where she'll play the winner of Nada Abbas and Nikki Todd. The next match will be on in around 5 or 10 minutes or so after the players have warmed up, and that will be between Maria Wazir and Samantha Cornett. And as we saw last night, the home crowd very, very supportive of Cornett. But Wazir is also a local favourite, so this one could be quite feisty in the stands. Divided crowd, and we'll be right back with that action. Welcome back to the action. Join me in the second game of the evening between Maria Torpaque-Wazir and Samantha Cornett. Those of you who watched yesterday will know that Samantha has just come off a massive, massive five-game match when she was down 11-2 in the first game. Lost the second game and reversed it to win 3-2. She'll be full of confidence. Maria having a much easier time of it through the first round. Winning in three against the French woman, Chloe Mezek. Both these players will be confident. Both of them will feel like this is a home match. Maria moved here a couple of years ago from Pakistan. And she lives in Toronto herself. Cornett very comfortable playing on the Toronto circuit. Both of these will look to impose themselves early on the game. But this may well go to five. Contrasting styles between the two players. And we should see that early on in the first game. We'll be joined after the first game by Tomlinson. She can talk about their victory. If you have any questions you want to ask her, drop us a message in the YouTube comment stream and we'll put them to Tomlinson. Always good to have insight from these pro players on tour. They're just getting ready, coming off court. Last minute stretches. Welcome back, and it's Maria to serve. Maria Torpaque in blue, Sam Cornett in white, and we have another question on the comment stream from Rowan, asking who's the favorite. Oh, that's a great drop shot from Cornett there. And going from the world rankings, you'd have to say it is Maria. But after yesterday's action, Cornett will be incredibly confident. Cornett has been up to the 40s in the world rankings, and she's been out with injury. And judging from yesterday's action, she's looking at getting back into the kind of form that saw her reach those heights. Oh, that's a fantastic drop. And we saw this yesterday from Maria. She's pushing very high on the court, and she'll look to pick off those shots. Cornett will have to be very, very tight to avoid those shots. And I don't think you'll see the same hostile atmosphere on court as the previous match. Both these players very, very nice. Not to say the other two aren't, but they tend to be very calm on court. Extremely focused on the squash. Tight shot. And Cornet looking a lot more comfortable in this opening game than she was in the opening game yesterday. And that's down from Torpeke. Ball's out of the court there. And Cornet goes to a 5-2 lead. Oh, and that's a fantastic drop shot. We should see a replay of that soon. Oh, and that's a lovely shot. There's no chance of getting that. And she's 6-2 up now. She'll be absolutely delighted how she's bounced back from those earlier games yesterday. Should be a let. Let's see what the referee gives. Well, the referee's not giving a let. We should say in these tournaments that the loser from the previous game refs the next match. So if you remember some of those calls from El Torque in the previous game, should be indicative of the kind of decision she'll be making in this match. Not to say they're unfair, but everyone's definition of a let and stroke differs. That should be a let there. It's a very subjective game. But the ref will maintain those decisions for both players. So early on, they'll draw the line as to what is a let and what is a stroke from these early exchanges, and then that'll be used throughout the match. Can be tricky when you're a ref and if you make a bad call. It's not unheard of for refs to come on after the first game and say that they made a mistake and they'd like to reset the definition of a stroke and let. But at this kind of level, most of the markers are incredibly confident. They don't tend to make too many mistakes. Cornet's got a 9-4 lead in the first game. She'll be absolutely delighted. But do not discount Torpeke. Very strong player. Very powerful on the court. And she can really drive her way back into this. And she takes an early drop there. Oh, nice drop from the back. Always difficult to pick those one up. You're not expecting them. Oh, that's a great cross court. And she's got game ball. Oh, it's a fantastic drop. Lovely drop from Cornet. You can hear the crowd really getting behind the Canadian. Maria letting out some exasperation there. But a good game of squash, and we'll be back in a few minutes with an interview with Tomlinson. Welcome back to the second game. Maria Topakai-Wazir is in the blue and Samantha Cornett is in the white. We're getting some questions in as the game progresses, so send us your questions in and we should try and answer them live on air. Tomlinson is still going through a warm down procedure, so we're going to push that back to the second game. These players trying to get recover as quickly as possible, get into shape for the next day's action. Can build up a lot of lactic acid in the legs, and they'll try and feel as comfortable as possible, as quickly as possible after the match. Those first 10, 15 minutes after a game is very, very important for the recovery of these players. Ooh. Good aggressive play from Maria there. She'll look to correct that scoreline early on. Cornette just getting stuck at the front of the court. Zipper 12 asking on YouTube if the loser of the previous match is the referee for the next match, and that is the case. That is how this tournament is being operated. The winner avoids marking. Oh, and that's a great shot. It's a fantastic shot there. She'll be really pleased with that. Another one of those aggressive drop shots. Very tight. And that's the difference between this game and the last for Maria. She's taking that ball earlier. She's being far more aggressive with those drop shots. Josh is asking on the stream what happens when the timer runs out. That's the inter-game timer. Normally, the players get around 2 minutes between the games to talk to their coaches, to stretch out, take on advice and plan the next game, take on some fluids. And the marker will give a call at 30 seconds and 15 seconds to get the players back on court and ready for the next game. Not necessarily a strict timer in these kind of tournaments. The refs can be a bit more lenient. Oh. And she's frustrated. She's tinned that there. Oh, she got that. Oh, she got that. It's difficult to see from this camera angle, but you can see on the replay that she picked that one up. Oh, that's a fantastic shot. And that'll be a let. That drop shot, fantastic. Can be deceptive. It's a great drop. She's asking for a let. I don't know whether she'll get it. 6-4. No, she's not been given it. The drop shot was too good. High quality squash here from both players. Oh, and that's a nice cross court post lob. Players having a laugh with each other. 7-4. She's tinned that. She's frustrated with herself. But that is a bit of a lucky shot from Cornette. Can happen. Ball bounces up high, but it's too tight in the wall to return. They all count. Oh, she's tinned that post. She's looking to recover straight away, but when you try too hard, it can go against you. Good aggressive play on the tee there from Cornette. She's just riding out a bit of pressure, but that's too much pressure from Torpiqué. It's a great hard cross-court shot. There's nothing Cornette can do. And draws the applause from the crowd. Oh! That is a delicious, delicious cross-court drop from Cornette. That is not getting the applause that it deserves. And Maria tries to follow with the same shot, just not as precise, but it's got her on the tee, and she's forced the error. Scream from Cornette in exasperation. She won't worry too much. She's got game ball. Oh, and that is a great recovery. Good width from Torpiqué. Always difficult to pick those ones out of the air. They're moving hard. They're moving fast through the air. Oh, some great reaction squash going on. Oh, and she's tinned it. And Cornette takes a 2-love lead. In stark contrast to her match yesterday, I'm sure she'll be significantly happy with that opening performance. Hopefully we'll be joined with Tomlinson in a few minutes. If not, we don't want to interrupt her warm down routines. All of these players have different routines after these matches, so we'll try and get her on. If not, we'll discuss some of your questions and join back for the third game of action. We're back live from the Granite Club in a few minutes. And welcome back. We're in the third game. Hornet leading Torpokay 4-1. And I'm joined with Tomlinson here. So how was that match? How do you feel?
Yeah, it was a good match. Very tight for a 3-love, I think. Probably closer than the score makes it look.
Yeah. How do you feel coming off the court?
Are you ready for the next day? Yeah, not too tired for tomorrow, but yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
What will you be doing tonight to get yourself ready for the next day of action? What's your routine normally when you come off court? Other than avoiding interviews, obviously.
Yeah, obviously, hiding from interviewers. probably just have like a nice meal tonight, some pasta or something, a bit of carbo loading, try and get a good sleep.
Do you go for the ice bath? Or do you avoid it?
I have done ice baths before, but not tonight, I don't think.
We do have some comments on the live stream from Sam F. Well, saying that he reckons it'll be you and Cornet in the final. What do you think about that?
Wait, who's that from?
This is someone called Sam F. Well on YouTube.
Oh, right, okay.
And they reckon it'll be you and Cornet in the final. What do you reckon about that?
I'm not sure. The next round will be tough.
Yeah, it'll be a close game. Who are you playing in the next round here?
I think it's either Nada or Nikki.
Yeah. And Nada had a great game yesterday. Did you catch that match?
Yeah, I didn't watch it, but yeah, the score looked like she was pretty solid.
She's playing well.
Nicolette's a good player, so she must have played well.
Well, she's very young to be dispatching Nicolette
exactly,
like that
in
three. So that should be hopefully, well, it depends how she gets on with Nikki Todd, but that could go either way.
Yeah, that'll be a close match, yeah.
So did you with Cornet having that 5-game match yesterday?
Mm-hmm.
Will she be feeling that now in this game? Will she be looking to wrap this one up in three and get back some of that energy in the legs in comparison to someone like yourself that's only had a 4-game?
Yeah, I mean it's obviously not ideal to have had a 5-setter, but I think Sam's pretty fit and she'll be used to training like twice a day anyway,
yep.
So she should be able to cope with it.
And Maria seems to be struggling with the consistency of Cornet. She's not going for too many kills. She's just keeping it nice and simple.
Yeah, Sam's just so solid, like great length.
And she was saying yesterday that when she went 2-0 down, she cut out all attempts at a kill shot whilst playing and just back to basics, keeping it nice and tight and clear. And she seems to have just carried that forward today.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, she volleys well and she's consistent.
Have you played both these players on tour?
Yeah, I have, yeah.
Who do you prefer to play? Who matches your style better?
I definitely prefer to play Sam.
Ooh, why is that?
Maria's kind of tricky to play.
Yeah, she's very aggressive on the court and
she's
riding high and she has a lot of kills.
Yeah.
But Sam seems to be handling her very well.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Well, she's in front of a home crowd as well, isn't she?
Yeah, she's getting a bit spurred on.
Yeah.
Oh, and that's a great shot. She's looking really fired up on court. She's normally smiling
yeah.
and joking around, but she looks incredibly serious now on court.
Yeah, so focused.
Oh. And she's lovely replayed. She's not ready.
Mm-hmm.
So is it a bit of added extra motivation to win the game so you don't have to mark the next match?
Yeah, or a bit, yeah. I hate reffing. So.
Yeah, I think most players, cross players, yeah. hate reffing.
So much pressure, isn't there?
And if there's any new players, you know, or people thinking about taking up the sport out there, what would you mm-hmm. say to them? What's the best way to get into squash? Why did you get into squash in the first place?
My dad played, so, and we lived like 5 minutes away from a squash club, so I guess it's convenient for me. But I'd definitely say just try it. Everyone gets addicted to it straight away.
Oh, and
that's a great rally.
You can see great rally there.
Yeah.
Very aggressive on the ball from both players. What would you say is the differences between the English game, as a few of the people watching the stream will be, will have that more of a style compared to the Canadian style?
I think the English and Canadian style is quite similar.
Mm-hmm.
Probably very different kind of Maria style and the yep. Egyptian style, like consistent lengths.
If you watch
running a lot,
particularly the Egyptian players, they'll take a lot more boasts.
Yeah, exactly.
Back
yeah.
of the court.
More confident, a bit more flair, probably.
Yes. So it's reliability versus flair, and
yep.
they always do make exciting games when you
yeah,
have that mismatch
do.
Of styles. Maria's having to work very hard here. She's dragged herself back to 9-7. Oh, and she's got a great sell. Sold the cross court and pushed that down the line.
8-9.
Uber for Sam.
8-9.
Yeah. This one could go to 4. Sam will be looking to keep this one to... Oh! Some scrappy squash. But she's not letting this go. And I think that's the real difference between you pro players when you're playing compared to the recreational players. When that does go scrappy, you recover really well and it goes back to a normal rally.
Yeah, so it's just get yourself back into the rally and reset, don't you?
And I think that's a very difficult skill to kind of master.
Yeah.
How do you build your fitness up in the off season before playing? Like, what's your go-to?
In the summer, I suppose it's a lot of like interval training, like repeated 400 meter sprints, things like that. Short reps on the treadmill.
Do you look forward to that, or are you?
Actually, yeah, I used to do a lot of cross country growing up, so I love the running part. But
oh, and she's shots. Maria's not letting this game go.
Yeah, the weights is the bit that I don't like.
You don't like the weights?
Yeah.
No. Oh, that's a great kill.
Massive comeback.
She's tied that up at 10-10.
10 on.
Oh, that's a great finish. And there's absolutely nothing you can do when someone finishes the ball
yeah,
like
exactly,
that.
Yeah.
There's no chance.
Who do you think's going to take it?
I mean, the vast majority of viewers are Canadian, so
oh,
it
right,
would be...
Okay.
Oh, very
sure.
foolish of me to say that anything other than Cornette.
Mm-hmm.
But it's she's 11-10 up now and she's got match ball.
Oh, nice shot.
But as we've seen already today, having a lead in a game does not necessarily mean... Oh, just as I was about to say that it could swing the other way. Cornette takes it in 3, 11-5, 11-7, 12-10. Little hug from the players there. Obviously both very friendly off the court. And do you find that on the tour, most of the players are friendly? And
yeah, most of the girls are really nice, yeah.
Are there any,
yeah, it's nice
any little niggles, any rivalry that you have? You're not going to stay on air,
yeah,
but
exactly,
do they exist?
Yeah. No.
No, they don't exist.
Nice.
That's a very
yeah.
diplomatic answer.
Yeah.
So thank you for joining us.
Thanks,
do you
yeah.
want to say anything to those people watching back home in England?
Yeah, I guess
anybody
I'll say
to thank?
Hi to Matt and my sisters. Thanks for supporting me.
Awesome. Right, we'll be back in around 2 minutes or so, oh, about 5 minutes or so with the next game. With the next match, and that'll be between Nada Abbas and Nikki Todd, who will be playing Tomlinson in the semi-finals tomorrow. Okay, welcome back to the Slate Music 2016 Granite Open, live from the Granite Club in Toronto. I'm joined by Samantha Cornett, who's just come off that 3-0 win against Maria. How's that feel?
Good.
A lot more comfortable than yesterday?
Less edgy for sure, but it's still a pretty tough match in a very different way.
Yep. So how did you feel this morning, waking up, approaching this game? More confident than yesterday?
Felt kind of, you know, freer. Because once you have that first one under your belt, things will just happen from there, whether you win or lose. It's nice to have a win in the first round, for sure.
And without being too confident, we seem to have someone saying on the stream that they reckon it'll be you and Tomlinson in the final. Well, you want to comment on that?
Do you reckon? I would love that.
You would love that? I'm sure the crowd would love that. They're excellent here, really supporting the Canadian players.
Yeah. And the crowd would love Nikki in the final. That is for sure. Nikki and I. That would be amazing.
It's a fantastic drop shot there.
Yeah, right, she's got a lot of those.
It would be a fantastic achievement to get to that final and push forward and have a great game there.
Yeah.
But, the crowd has really been really supportive of these players. Even the non-Canadians, they've been getting behind.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a really good crowd so far.
It's a really good club. Good club atmosphere here.
Good vibe.
So we spoke yesterday about Nada on the tour. Mm-hmm. What is it like playing with such a young player around? Do you have a mentor role with these younger players on tour? Is that something you like about being a professional squash player?
It's hard to compare Nada. I would love to mentor like Canadian players, of course. But when you're playing someone like a Nada, I've played even younger, and the first time I played someone that was quite a bit younger than me, it was right in my head. And I was thinking, I can beat this person. They're so young. And you actually have to just erase that from your brain, their age, because it really doesn't matter. They've probably been playing squash longer than I have. And age is...
Well, the Egyptian players play from birth, right?
Yeah, exactly.
They're born with a squash racket in their hands.
Age is not as much of a factor in squash.
I mean, off the court, they probably find it quite difficult being away from their families, and I'm sure how friendly everyone is off the court probably really helps them feel at home.
For sure. Same with everyone, again, no matter what age. But yeah, especially for a young player.
Who do you fancy in this match?
I haven't actually seen Nada play, but I think Nikki's speed will be a huge boost for her in this match, because she'll have a great counterattack, because I think Nada likes to attack a lot. So hopefully it works in Nikki's favor tonight.
Nada had an excellent game yesterday against Fernandez.
Nikki. Yeah.
Where she took a big scalp, and I'm sure she'll be very pleased with just taking that game.
Definitely.
But I'm sure she'll be pushing here to do the same.
Yeah. Fun fact about Nicolette is that I recently learned, I've known her for a long time, that it's not Fernandez, it's Fernandes.
It's Fernandes, but that doesn't make any sense.
Right, but it's Portuguese.
Aha.
That's how it's said in Portuguese.
So Fernandes, there we go. So I'm sure her family was watching at home on the stream and being very frustrated with my commentary yesterday.
No, I apologize. No, I talked to her about it, and she is totally at peace with it, I think.
Yeah, I'm sure it's a common miss. Oh, that's got to be a stroke.
Yeah,
that'd be given as a stroke. So you played Maria early on today. I mean, she's a very, very strong player on court.
Mm-hmm.
She hits the ball very hard.
Yep.
And we saw you do a lot to neutralize that. Can you just describe how you went about dealing with a player that's bringing pace into the play, and she's riding high on the tee, and how you go to mitigating those facts? Like, what did you do on court?
Well, one way is to actually have her hitting off her back foot. So pace works quite well. And if I can keep it nice and pace, and then but mixing up with slow stuff, because if you let her get into a rhythm, she's very happy to keep smashing the ball back at you, and keep you behind. So I couldn't let her get into that frame of mind, and I tried to keep her off balance. I think it worked.
And if any juniors are watching, I think your game against Maria was a prime example of keeping everything tight and simple.
Mm-hmm. And I tried to keep it simple,
And preventing that early drop.
Yeah.
And you were keeping it very tight to the wall, and there's not a lot.
It's hard to prevent that early drop, because she is capable of doing that. Oof.
That was a prime example of why sometimes the best option is to just keep a rally going and keep it tight.
Yeah.
So I think that's a big difference in the style between Canadian and British players and the Egyptian and Pakistani players. They tend to boast a lot more, they go for a lot more kills, especially if you watch Nada. Now she likes a good boast on this backhand side.
Yep. Nikki does too, so it's interesting.
Oh, you can see that boast. It's a great hold. Shot. She sold the drive and she cut that across.
Oh, I could watch her do that all day long.
So for those of you back home, it's Nikki Todd in the blue top and Nada Abbas in the black and fluorescent yellow top dress combo. One piece thing.
Don't stress about it.
Don't stress. And we mentioned yesterday, but Nada Abbas is relatively new on tour. She's 16. She took a big scout yesterday with a number one seed, 3-0. Against Nicolette Fernandes. There you go. I've got it right now.
Hopefully I have it right. Maybe she was messing with me.
Maybe she was messing with me. I'm sure she wasn't. But Nikki Todd had a comfortable game against Mendez. I'm sure she'd have wanted to be more comfortable and push ahead a little bit harder than she did in that match. It was, Mendez had chances.
It's it's also good that she was tested because she proved to herself that she could come back from being a little bit down, so I'm sure she's okay with it.
Oh, that's a great cross-court kill.
Nikki's got to stay very steady here. This is an important point right now.
Yeah. Especially with the juniors, they tend to go for a lot more drops. They're not as patient as the older players on tour.
So quite fearless, too.
Yeah,
right?
And she could rack up a fair few points with some fortunate drops. Yeah, she's already back to 6-9 now. 7-9 even.
Go.
That's
a tricky one because it's a good shot.
What would you give if you were marking this now?
I might have given a no let, but it's a tough call because she definitely tripped on her.
It's a very tight shot.
She's fast. Oh, that's a weird. That's a very strange backward. Oh.
It's a great slow-mo. And we'll see what Maria gives here. Wait for the decision.
I like you both.
She says she likes you both. She's obviously not biased. She's a character, isn't she?
She is.
I think it was a lap. It was given as a lap. So we saw a bit of contrast in your game with Maria than the previous game between Tomlinson and Torquay, where that was quite a bit argumentative from both players for some of the calls. Do you like to keep it friendly on court, or can you get a bit more aggressive when it needs to be?
It depends what is called for. I mean, typically I find it a lot easier to play when I'm not worried about arguing and what I'm going to say, you know. So I try and keep it simple. But sometimes you have to fight for yourself.
And I think you have to say that Nada is very, very calm on court for such a young junior. Sometimes the juniors can be quite frustrated on court, and they tend to get
very shouty. See what happens when it gets close. You never know. I mean, it's not just juniors.
Well, I mean, most players can get.
Yeah, whenever it gets close, that's when that's when
start
stuff
fraying.
Comes out, right?
That was out of the court.
9-all.
So she's dragged that back from 9-5. So what do you try and do in those situations when you're down 9-5, a couple of points away from losing the game? How do you keep yourself calm on court?
9-5 is not a bad spot for me to be. I don't mind it. I've come back from it a lot because you just kind of relax. I mean, Nada's just stayed steady. She hasn't done much. Nikki's thinking about the end.
Yep.
When you're down 9-5, you're in a good position.
She was saying yesterday that during a match with Nicolette, she didn't worry about the score. She wasn't even worried about the match. She was just
trying to
play. And she's lost that game 11-9. That's a good performance from Nada there. Bring that back from 9-5. But she was saying that on court, she wasn't really concerned with the score, that she's just happy to be on tour and enjoying it at the moment.
Yeah,
I think that's
cool.
A really refreshing attitude to have.
Yeah.
So we've got a little bit of time now between games. They go off. What did you do in between games? What's your routine when you come off after these? What do you like to go through?
I just like to find somewhere quiet. And mm-hmm. It depends how I finish the game. Like you kind of judge if you finish the game and your energy's a little low, see if you can find a way to bring it up, whether like it's kind of, you know, hopping around in between games, or sometimes I just need to sit there and put a towel over my face and just have like a little quiet moment to myself.
And I think a lot of recreational players try and consume too much food or like fluids in between these games, so they end up getting a stitch or a cramp on court.
Interesting.
What about yourself? Would you just
don't really get any cramps?
You just have a light.
Yeah, just a light sip, but if you're cram hydrating, then yeah, you're probably gonna get a cramp or something. Because I'm like, what do I do all day? I get ready for my match, right?
Yep.
That's all. I'm not working or anything. I'm just working as a squash pro, but I'm focused on being hydrated and properly nourished. So.
And it can be tempting as well when you come off court and you're
really
sweating
thirsty
and tired
to just
down it, and that's a
an issue.
And speaking, but of course you're not going on. You're ready for your next game in the semis. You'll be playing the winner between the last game of the day, Turan and Norton. Who do you want? Who are you more comfortable playing?
Similar game style, like hard hitters. Mm-hmm. I'm not really picky. I'm excited. I hope it goes to five.
You hope it goes
to
five?
Everyone does, yeah. Good hour.
A good
match.
Hour of squash.
Yeah, that'd be great.
I'm sure the crowd appreciated a longer game yesterday from you.
Yes.
If there's any questions that anyone wants to ask, send us in. So we have a question from Colin, which is, it's tough to get competitive women matches outside of the tour, and there's a smaller pool of players at the club level, and he says that you often train and play with men for these tune-up matches, and that does help, or does it hurt you when you're getting ready to play these tour games, and what are the differences between the games, and how do you approach playing men versus how you approach playing women?
Interesting.
That's an interesting question from Colin. Thanks for that.
Yeah. I don't really think too much about it. I don't overanalyze it. If I can have like a really good match with a guy that like I'd choose someone that I go to five with. Mm-hmm. It's more about the mental, for me, it's more about the mental approach of getting in the zone of winning and winning at whatever method I need to win against whoever it is. So I'm not picky about, you know, guy or girl. Just as long as I know it's going to be a close match, those are the ones that I'll play before a tournament.
Oh, that's a great boast. She'll be happy. She's settled well in this first game. I don't think it'll affect her too much going down in the first game.
She's got lots of energy. She's like an energizer bunny.
Ooh.
Just got to stay off that.
I think there's a bit of a curse of a commentator here. Every time one of us says, that's a good shot, the other player tins it. It was happening in the previous game as well. I think I jinxed you. I think I have to apologize for all of your tins. It's entirely my fault.
It's all your fault. No, I can't blame you for that one where I tried to hit a weird cross court when I had no business doing it. That was all me.
Both these players are playing really high up on the court. It does make exciting squash.
Go!
Oh,
shot.
That is a nick. Fantastic nick.
3-2.
Okay. Got a biased commentator.
The biased commentator. Well, I mean, you're bound to be.
Am I fired?
A Canadian.
Yeah.
No, you can't be fired. So what's next for you after this tournament? Where will we be off to?
Sunday, headed to Vancouver.
Ooh.
For a 10K.
Nice. Are most of these girls be going as well?
I think quite a few, yeah.
So it might be a repeat. So it'd be good if you claim this one.
Yeah,
that
should be amazing, yeah. Come on, Nick.
4-2.
Ball. So Natalie leaves this one 4-2. Nikki will look to push back. Neither of them look uncomfortable. They all look pretty happy out there playing. Mm-hmm. And how do these courts compare with some of the ones on tour? The facilities seem quite nice here.
Yeah, I quite like the courts. This is my home club, so I'm used to it. Some of the girls said it's kind of unforgiving. If you don't hit a good line, then it pops out. But I think it's pretty normal. Maria and I played with a really dead ball, so I was struggling to get it to the back. Mm-hmm. These guys are exchanging errors.
Hold on.
But I think it's a pretty simple court. There's no strange nicks or anything like that, which is nice.
How do you prefer playing on a court like this, you know, a hard court, hardball court, versus an all-glass court, say, in a show court? Because I think a lot of recreational players don't get the opportunity to do that. Mm-hmm. And what is that like, especially when they switch the ball to the different rubber, the white rubber ball?
It's very different. It's really fun. It's only fun when you get to play on a glass court. Pretty cool experience, and it's usually at a cool event in a cool location. So I've only ever had great experiences. It's hard to get to see the ball, so the practice in the morning before your match is very important. Shot.
And we have a question from Karim on YouTube, which says, do you think that Nada can break into the top 30 soon?
Sure, yeah.
I mean, she's 61 at the moment in the world, I think, and she's 16, so...
There's a lot of competition out there, holy. She's certainly not the only good young player. But I mean, she's pretty solid, and she looks like, you know what, like that's a prime example. It looks like she's enjoying herself, which I think is very important.
Yeah, big smile on court.
Yeah.
She won't be worried about any tins or shots out. She's just there to make a mark.
It's a fine balance, the dance between not being worried about the tin, but also
That was ridiculously tight from Nikki there.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Super glued to the wall. Oh, there's no getting that out.
Off another tight one.
Sometimes it can be easier to hit a tight drive off of a tight drive, and that can be frustrating when you're the player that hit the first tight drive.
Yeah, it can be very frustrating. You know who's good at that is Maria. She can volley those high backhands.
It's a fantastic drop, and you hear the crowd applauding that.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's the
show that all night.
Out of court. This is a very close game. Sometimes a lot of these matches can be 3-love and 3-1, and it can really have swung either way.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, that's a great drop.
Nikki looks like she's got a good game plan, and she actually looks quite confident in it. So I hope that she can pull it the other way. Come on.
You seem to be quite popular on the old question stream here. So we've got Ryan Moffett, who says, how high do you want to get into the world rankings? What is your goal?
If it's Ryan Moffett that's from here at the Grand Club, that's really cute. Hi, Ryan.
I'm sure he'll be just around the corner.
He's probably around the corner.
I could have asked you that in person.
But how high do I want to get?
Yeah, where will you be happy? Where will you be content at the end of your career to have reached?
Number one, as I'm sure everyone in the world does. And I'm in it for the long haul, so I'm in no rush. I'll do it. I'll take number one whenever I get it. Good call.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's a good call.
9-7.
Very honest. But that is a fantastic drop. Right into the corner. Ooh. Yep. It can be frustrating when you get your racket on the end of the ball and you scooped it up. Mm-hmm. Some good play down this backhand side. There she is, punishing that mistake. You see the fist pump? Bit of emotion coming through.
Game ball.
Nice, great shot. Oof.
So difficult to get. She's got game ball.
She's just quietly doing her thing, pushing ahead.
She's not putting any pressure on herself. I'm sure she was saying that her family was watching the previous match, and they'll be watching, I'm sure, tonight, and they'll be very happy to see her perform as well. So she's two level up. So what would you do in Nikki's situation now? Oh, that's a great boast.
Nikki's got to take a lot more space, I think. Mm-hmm. She's going to have to push her back and pretty straight, not give her too many angles. She's got a great kill on Nada, so going to have to neutralize that.
And, I mean, she's in a similar situation that you were yesterday. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it would be great for Canadian squash if she comes back
come
and takes a 3-2 win. But well, we'll have to wait and see. Yep. So we'll be back. We'll take a short break now, and we'll be back for the third game. Nada Abbas is up 2-0 against Nikki Todd. Bye, Sam. We'll see you tomorrow. Hopefully we'll have another interview when you win in the semis tomorrow and set yourself up for a final.
Yeah, thanks guys for the streaming. It's awesome.
So I'll tell you what, we'll schedule you in for an interview.
See you tomorrow.
And we'll see you tomorrow. Right, thank you.
Thank
you. We'll catch you guys later on in around a minute or so for the third game. Welcome back to the 2016 Slate Music Granite Open. Joining us in the third game between Nikki Todd and Nada Abbas, the 16-year-old from Egypt. And she's in the black with fluorescent stripes. And Nikki Todd is in the blue. Nikki will be looking to push back from this two-game deficit. We were speaking to Samantha Cornett in the break there. Throughout the last game, a bit of insight into how these players approach these matches. If you have any more questions, we'll pose it to the winner of this match. Well, at the moment, it's looking like it's going to be Nada Abbas, but that is a fantastic shot from Nikki Todd. And if you watched yesterday's day of action, you'll know that these girls can change the score very quickly. Samantha Cornett coming from 2-down to win 3-2. And that was down. Nikki Todd's got an early lead in this game. Just looking to bounce back after that 2-game loss. Oh, she still get a stroke for that. That is given as a stroke. You can see the look on Nikki's face there. She knows it's a stroke. Difficult one to clear. Oh, it's a very tight play. A little bit looser from Nada in this game, but that should be a let. ferocious backhand drive. Fantastic drop. Great recovery from Nikki Todd. But that's good width, and she applauds that shot there. Bit of acknowledgement from the Canadian. Fantastic play from both these players. Great cross-court shot. Oh, that's good recovery. Oh, and she's tinned it. Like we were saying earlier, when we were talking to Tomlinson, that these players are so good at recovering the ball and getting back in control in a rally. It's a big difference between the recreational game and the pro game. They're very comfortable getting back on the tee. Incredible athletes. Could have probably called that then. Didn't need to. Great boast. Oh, she should get a stroke for that.
Stroke.
It's been given.
Six all.
It's up to six all. Very difficult to get out of the way there. From Nikki Todd. You can hear the crowd getting behind the Canadian, trying to spur her on.
7-6.
A great shot. Fantastic shot from Nikki there. Lovely early drop. We've got a couple of questions on the channel. Krim asks, who do we think are going to be the finalists? And that's very tricky. Oh, that's been given as a let there. It's a tough call. I think it's going to be very tricky to decide here. I think the winner of this does have a shout. Then again, Tomlinson does have a shout as well. It's very difficult to call a winner here. I mean, if I have to go with my head, I have to think it might be Norton and Tomlinson. But it'd be nice to see the 16-year-old reach a final. Nice to see the crowd favourite, Sam Cornett, reach the final as well. But anything can happen in these tournaments. Oh, Very tight on the wall there. Oh, and a fantastic change of pace with that boast. Drawing the error from Nikki there.
8-all.
It's 8-all. Very close. I don't think a 3-love would do this match justice. Well worked in that rally from Todd. She's moving the youngster around. And cutting that short. Playing a safer drop. She's had a few tins. I watch a lot of the players do that in their game. If they're struggling with the height on the drop, they'll just raise it up. They'll go for the safe drop. And try and engineer a situation where it doesn't matter. And I don't think she'll get a let for that. It's been given as a no let. Oh, it's a fantastic early drop. It really brings back the control of the rally when you can hit a shot like that. She's got that in her locker. A little bit of interference on the players there, but they're playing through it. Oh, and she should get a let from that. She's after the stroke, but it won't be given. You can hear the crowds trying to spur the Canadian on. If you're joining us now, Nada Abbas is 2 games up, 9-all in the third. Very close game. That's the youngster from Egypt playing in black with the experienced Canadian playing in blue.
Yes,
and that should be a let.
Yes,
9-all. Oh. Sending in your questions if you have any questions for the players.
Yeah, yes,
we'll ask it to the victor when we have their post-game interview. That's given us a let, just catching the racket there. Can be a frustrating one. Sometimes you can break the opponent's racket. It's an expensive, let there. Now that's got good contrast between that explosive backhand drive and that soft boast. And she's used that to effect there. Engineering a match ball. It's match ball for the 16-year-old. And I think you can hear on the stream there the crowd trying to spur Nikki Todd on. They sense a comeback. Should be a let.
10-9 match ball.
That's been given as one. Difficult to get through there. Oh, that's a fantastic get from that drop. Ooh. And she's taken that with a stroke. Oh, and she looks upset to have won that game by a stroke, but it all counts, and it definitely is a stroke. I'm sure Nikki will be disappointed, but I'm sure she'll accept that Nada played an excellent game there. And that's the 16-year-old Egyptian taking another 3-0 victory in the second round against a seeded player after beating Nicolette Fernandes yesterday. 3-love. And she's well on the way through to the semi-finals, where she will face... where she will face Tomlinson tomorrow at 7 o'clock when the streaming starts, tomorrow at 7. We're going to take a short break now, around 5 or 10 minutes or so before the next match. The next match should be at 8:15, so and that'll be the final match of the day, so about a 5-minute break. We should have Nada on. I'm sure she'll want to call her family and tell her the good news, and then we'll get her on for an interview. And if you want to send us some questions you want to ask, that'll be fantastic. And we'll catch up to you in a few minutes. And welcome back to the Slate Music Granite Open. I'm joined here with Nada Abbas after that great 3-0 victory against
you.
Nikki Todd. She's spoiling the hearts of the Canadian locals, but I'm sure she's happy with that win. So how did that feel?
Yeah, it feels amazing. Like, it's my first semi-final of a 15K tournament, so I really wanted it so much.
You must be absolutely ecstatic. Yesterday coming in, winning 3-love. Today coming in, winning 3-love, and you're playing Millie Tomlinson tomorrow. Are you going to go for a trio of 3-loves, or do you think that might be a bit more difficult?
It will be a bit more difficult. Like, I played Millie 2 times before.
Yep.
I lost in 3 games, but it was really close. So I'm sure that this one will be much better, and I will do my best to win.
I mean, it'd be absolutely fantastic if you can get towards the semi, and you have to start thinking you can push forward onto a final and take home the win. If you've got some questions for Nada on the YouTube stream, send them in. We'll ask them and get them going. So what did you do last night when you went home? How did you prepare yourself for today?
Like, I stretched more, and I stopped, like, thinking of the match, and, like, I was really happy winning Nicolette because she's, like, a top player. Mm-hmm. So I stopped thinking in the match. I started thinking in the next match and thinking how to play with Nikki. Because, you know, it will be a tough one because I'm playing her in her hometown, in her club. So it will be a tough one. So I was concentrating more than yesterday to play and do my best to win.
And you look completely calm on court today. It's that same attitude from yesterday. Were you just trying to keep calm?
Yes, but, like, today I was a bit nervous because, like, I didn't want to lose after knocking out the number one seed. So I was a bit nervous.
And will it be the same again tonight? Will you go home and try and push this out, start afresh every day?
Even concentrating more on the match.
Good. We have a question coming through on the live stream at the moment. It's a little bit of a silly one. Someone wants to know what your favorite sandwich is. So if you're playing, you've got a long tournament and you're having it midday, what's your ideal snack? Like, in a squash snack for those young players out there, what do you recommend? It's a difficult one. It's a difficult one. See, when I used to play for the juniors back in England, we used to have at the local club where we used to do all these junior competitions for, like, the England scene. We used to have cheesy chips that players were coming off. So you get all these. I know quite a few players now that are pushing onto the men's pro tour who were raised on cheesy chips at the end of matches. I think that's you know, we're high quality squash here, high in nutrition. So, I mean, who would you fancy playing out of these two in the final? If you get through to, you know, if you push through to the final, this is in the second half of the draw, which one of these two players would you prefer to meet? That's a tough one.
Like, I played Holy before.
Mm-hmm.
I lost in 5.
Oh, that's a great drop from Taran there. Taran's very experienced on tour.
She's very experienced.
I think just how difficult is it playing these players on tour when they get in front of you on the court, on the tee, and they're going for that drop. How hard is it to get round them and take back control?
I try not to play, like, silly shots in the middle of the court, so I won't be in this situation. So,
I mean, watching you play very high up on the court. Is that something you think differs with the Egyptian game versus a lot of the Canadian and English game?
Of course, yeah.
Yeah. Is that something you work on in training, playing nice and high?
Yes.
Yeah. What's your favorite drill?
Favorite drill?
Yeah. Or do you not have a favorite drill? Do you not like practice?
No. There's no favorite drill. But I like to play, like, lots of drives and low drives, and that's one of my favorite shots. Like, it puts, like, pressure on the other player.
I think that should be a let there. Mm.
Yes.
We'd hope. Ooh. Maybe we'll get a slow-mo on the trip. How do you prepare yourself when you're about to get ready to go on tour? We heard that Tomlinson does a lot of interval training, a lot of running. She used to be a cross-country runner. And what about yourself? What kind of fitness work do you do so you can cope with these
I
matches?
I try like oh, to do more shot. Fitness on court mm-hmm. to like my legs know the movement well. And I'll I do like in the track for more, how do you say it? for breathing.
Yeah, for breathing yeah. exercises. Yep.
But mainly all of my fitness is on court.
Oh, she's unlucky there. How is that when you're playing these matches when maybe you're a little bit down and you're tin a ball? How do you try and push that out of your head?
I try not like to play more in the back of the court because I'm already down, so I don't have to do lots of more errors. So I try to just put pressure in my drives and just gaining point after point.
I think someone asked a question earlier on. They asked Sam Cornette whether they thought you were going to push into the top 30 in the world soon. She said that she thinks that you're going to get there relatively soon.
I hope so.
How high do you want to go? What's the ambition?
Like for the near target or like the target in the this
let's
year?
Let's say this year's target and then
this
5 year
to
target.
In the top 40.
This year?
Yeah.
And what about
like
5 years?
5 years, number one.
Number one. They all yeah. say number one. Who's your favorite player on the tour at the moment?
My favorite player, Amanda Sowby.
Yep.
And Noor Shirbini.
Oh, the great players.
Yes.
You know Nicole David?
Of course, Nicole is a legend.
Have you played any of those yet, or are you going to come? It's going to come up soon, right?
Sorry?
You might get drawn against those soon in future tournaments.
So.
I can't imagine what that will be like, playing an idol on court. Oh, she's asking for a let there. I don't think that's been given. Has that been given? Don't think that's been given. No, that's a no let. Holly's really struggling. 9-6. Taran's hitting the ball very, very deep here. She's using all of her experience. Do you find yourself watching a lot of squash during your downtime? Or do you try and completely separate after you've played?
No, I don't.
You don't watch any
no.
squash? No, completely separate.
Yes.
I think that's good. Keep it out of your mind. Oh, so tight. Taran's been absolutely clinical with that whiff. Oh, she's asking for a let. I think it's going to be given, but I don't necessarily know whether I would have given that as a let. Oh, that is a fantastic
yes.
drop. It's a great drop from Holly. And how is that on court when maybe you don't exactly agree with the decision from a marker? How do you try and keep yourself calm?
I try just don't think about what he said and keep playing mm-hmm. because I don't want to like put pressure on myself and think a lot and get angry. So I let it go.
You can see Holly getting very frustrated with the number of lets going on court now. That is given as a let. Taran's so ready on that tee. She's extremely focused. She'll want to take this. Oh, but that's a very, very tight drive. 8-10. What's it like playing a left-handed player? Do you change your game?
Of course I change my game, yeah. Mm-hmm.
But
it's harder. It's harder because I like to play on the backhand side more than the forehand side.
Mm-hmm. I can see that you're
yeah.
very strong on that side.
And usually, most of the lefties like their right hand side are really good. Mm-hmm. So I have to change my game and play more on my forehand side. so it's a bit different.
Oh, that's a fantastic boast. And that's a great game. Is there anything you want to say before you leave us? You want to thank anybody on the camera?
Yeah, I would like to thank, Noron for helping me and everyone in the tournament. It's a great tournament.
And yeah, it's good. All right, so thank you, Nada. And we'll be back with the second game of this match. And we'll be live from the Granite Club in Toronto, sponsored by Slate Music. Welcome back to the 2016 Slate Music Granite Open, and you're joining us in the second game of this close match between Samantha Turan and Holly Norton. That's Norton in the white, Turan in the orange. Oh, it's a fantastic early drop. Turan has been dominant in the early exchanges. She's firmly planted on that tee, but Norton will look to come back strong from this. Be nice to have another Canadian progress through the draw. The winner of these will be playing Sam Cornett in the next round in the semis, and that'll be tomorrow at 7:45. If you have any questions about the game, if you're watching and you're new to squash, or you have any questions as an experienced player for some of the pros afterwards, we'll put your question to the winner. Oh, it's a fantastic cross-court drop. And some real top quality squash on display. Fantastic opportunity for the Granite Club members to see these pros in action. And we have to thank the Granite Club for sponsoring this as well and raising some of the funding. Oh, that's a great drop. She's starting to engineer a few of these points a bit better now, looking a lot more comfortable on the ball. You see, the title sponsor of this tournament is Slate Music. They do a lot for Canadian talent and are really supporting squash in Canada by providing a good chunk of the funding for this event. They work on developing Canadian talent in the music industry, by making tight strategic partnerships in industry. And the owner is a strong supporter of squash in Canada. And the keen squash player himself, as most supporters tend to be. It's very fortunate to be in Toronto, to have these sponsors bringing these players into the city. And those of you who tuned in yesterday will have heard me talk about financial struggles on tour, especially Fiona Moberly, who took a 5-year gap. Oh, a fantastic drop. And it is a problem. Most of these women will work as squash pros at clubs in order to raise a bit of money, when the more ideal situation would be on being on the court 24/7, really working on the game. And if you're watching this at home and are starting to get more interested in watching live professional squash, don't just watch it on a stream. Find a local tournament where the pros are coming in your area, get yourself a ticket, and really help to get these tournaments going. It's a fantastic shot. Oh, that is dead. And she apologizes, but there's no need to apologize there. A tight drop. Taran is drawing on a lot of her experience. She's really moving the ball. She's making the court very, very big for Holly. Oh, and she's got the inside post. Oh, this is a great rally. And we were talking earlier about how quickly the players get comfortable on the ball again after a frantic exchange. And you can see that here. Oh, and she's broken up that. She's broken up that exchange with Alette there. Norton pleading with the ref that it should be an Olette. I have to say I'm inclined to agree. But these players are very quick. And she may have got there. Error on the safer side and give Olette there from the ref. Oh, that's a great recovery lob. That's out of court. Unfortunate. You can just see from that court angle. And she really should have made an effort to go around rather than through there. The ref should be trying to stop that play, but she's given a let. You can really see from this court angle the imposing nature of Taran's game, but whew, Norton replies from those, some would say, dodgy let calls with an extremely aggressive cross-court volley nick. Those are the shots that we love to see, and they make the highlight reels. Oh, that's a great drop. Oh, that's a smash. Let's. Oh. She's getting a bit frustrated. Can be difficult. Emotions run high in these tournaments. Let us know what you think of the play on the comment stream. Let us know what you think of those calls. We always like to answer your questions and get you involved with the live stream. Let us know where you're watching from and who you fancy in this game. That is a fantastic boast. Taking that volley boast high and early. And there's no chance catching Taran flat-footed. It's Canada versus Mexico here. The Canadian in white and the Mexican in orange. Oh, and this is a great rally. Great pressure from Norton. But Taran has done excellent to regain control. Bring herself back into the rally. Reset it. Oh, scrappy squash. Norton will be looking to capitalize. Oh, great drop. Fantastic recovery from both players. Oh, fantastic drive. This is a mega rally. And in times like this as a player, you really want to win this point. Oh. Oh, and it's been given as a let. And the marker says, you put your butt out. Which is a fair point, as you can see from the replay. Clear impeding of play on the player let. The crowd applaud the ref for that comment. It's a fun atmosphere here at the Granite Club. Oh. And now Holly's taken the lead in this game for the first time. But like I say, it's a great atmosphere down here in the Granite Club in Toronto. It's a really nice club and facility. And it's a privilege to be commentating from a club like this. Oh, that's a fantastic shot from Taran. She's tying it up to 8-all. Very difficult to get across the court for those shots. Great squash. Oh, and a great finish. She took control. And she's not letting it go. She'll look to tie this one up. Oh, but that's Taran showing her experience on the court there. Keeping calm. Dispatching that volley drop. It's 9-all. Taran in the orange. Holly Norton in the white. That's a good boast. Oh, and she's picked that up with an excellent recovery lob. And that is the big difference between a great player and an excellent player, recovering from those drop shots. Again, fantastic lob, just resetting the point, taking back control. Fantastic drive. Oh, and a great finish. A little fist pump there, a come on from Holly Norton, spurring on the crowd. She's really feeding off that energy in the Granite Club tonight. Taran is really struggling now in this game. She had looked in control. You have to say that Norton is looking the stronger of the two at the moment. Oh, and she's got the tin. Fist pump, scream, applause from the crowds. And she's back at 1-all. Mirror result of the first game. They'll come off. And I'm sure Norton will be incredibly pleased with that performance. We'll be back with the action from the third game in around 2 minutes or so. And we're back at the 2016 Slate Music Granite Open. In the third game of a close match between Holly Norton and Samantha Turan. It's 1-1. And you can hear the players getting back on court again. And you can see a strong crowd out for this match. Samantha Turan in orange. Norton in white, an experienced Mexican player against the younger Canadian. Holly's the fifth seed for this tournament. She's up to 48th in the world. And she'll be looking to win a few more games and really push up the rankings. We'll look to capitalize on that success in the second game. Oh, and that's a great width. Fantastic width from Holly there. Drop us a comment on the YouTube stream. Let us know where you're watching from. Let us know if you have any questions. We'll try and get one of these two at the end of the match for a post-match interview. So queue up your questions for the players. Again, she's having a lot of joy with that cross court on her forehand side. She's a lefty, can make things difficult. We heard Nada Abbas talk about that earlier on. You've got to change your game. It can be hard. And that's a great drop shot. Ooh. I can hear Samantha Turan saying that should have been a let, but that's definitely should not have been called for a let. She's got the first point on the board in this third game. Holly using a lot of cross court backhand shots to good effect. She wants to get the ball on that forehand side. She's a lot stronger there. It's mismatched against Turan's backhand. She's having a lot of joy down that side. Turan's got to stay calm here, but that is a fantastic shot. 5-1. Fantastic shot from Norton, punishing the weak cross court. Turan's really got to get those cross court shots tighter, especially if she's putting them onto Norton's forearm. So some really tight play from both these players. Ooh, and she's a bit of interference. I'm sure Norton will have a word with the marker at the end of this. And we talked about players being friendly off court. A bit confrontational on court. But those are the fine lines which separate these players in world rankings. Fantastic drop and great recovery from Norton there. She'll be perfectly happy if the game stays down this forehand side. And oh, that's unnecessary charging from Turan when calling for that let. That's making a point. It's not very sportsmanlike. But she's got the let, and she's made the point. Oh, and Norton responds to that push in the best way possible with a cross-court nick. Oh, it's fantastic bows from Turan. Very experienced player on tour. It's a great drop shot.
4-6.
She thought about going for the let, but too far away. That drop shot is too good. Fantastic drop shot, but fantastic recovery, and that's just out of court. Turan acknowledges. She gets applause from the crowd for that. Perhaps restoring a bit of sportsman behaviour there. Oh, that is a ferocious drop. She's making a point. But Norton is absorbing this pressure well, and she should get a stroke for that.
It was right in front of you.
Yes, it's a clear stroke. Turan is not happy about that, but I'm sure if she watches the replay on squashstream.tv tonight, should agree that that was a stroke. If you're enjoying the coverage of this match, oh, that should never be a stroke or a let. That's a no let.
9-4.
That's given as a no let. If you're enjoying the coverage on squashstream.tv and on YouTube, and you're going to tune in tomorrow, tell a friend, get someone into squash. Let's get some more people tuning in to watch this fantastic ladies action. Oh, that's a great shot from Turan.
5-9.
She may get a let for that. It's been given as a let. It's a big thud against the wall. Great recovery, great kill, no chance. As she goes 10-5 up, opportunity to take the lead in this match, 2-1. Oh, and she hits it straight back at Turan. That's a bit feisty. Little bit of tension on court there. I'm not sure these two will be sharing a drink after this match at all.
6-10 game ball.
It's making for good viewing. She's tinned that, and she's given the game to Norton. So a fantastic third game of squash. Holly Norton's now 2-1 up, and she's looking very comfortable. She seems to have sussed Turan's game out, I'm sure an experienced player like Turan will look to respond in the fourth game. We'll be back in around a minute or so, bringing you action from the fourth game, live from the Granite Club in Toronto. Welcome back to the action between Holly Norton and Samantha Turan. Holly Norton up 2-1 in a close fought match. Samantha Turan is in orange. And the Canadian Holly Norton is wearing white, with the teal dress and the matching shoes. She's looking to take an early lead in this game. She's growing throughout this match. Comfortable on the ball. She's really worked out how to play against the experienced Turan here. And the number 5 seed is looking in ascension. It's been a feisty match. There's been a few confrontations on lets and strokes. And I'm sure that'll continue as we get closer to the conclusion. Some lovely drive play. The left-handed player, Norton, with an excellent cross-court drop. Turan has to try really hard not to present her with an opportunity like that. She's been too loose in this past 2 games or so. John Norton will welcome any loose shots, especially on that forehand side. Oh. She's stuck behind Turan there. She's done really well to engineer that shape. Make the court absolutely massive. There's a little push on Norton there. This is getting to be a very physical game. Bit of gamesmanship from both these women. Whoever said that squash is a non-contact sport is lying. And that'll be out of the court. Tran's doing well to force the mistake from Norton there. And tie the game up at 2-2. Great drive. You can just see Tran pushing high up on the court. She's found the resurgence of energy. She's really starting to take the game to Norton here. She's a very smooth player. The way she moves around the court. You can see all of experience. Another bit of contact there. I'm sure both these girls will be having words after the match. We'll try and get one of these to talk about that after the match in a bit of an interview, what it's like playing on a hostile environment like that. I'm sure both of these athletes will have experienced this before and know exactly what to do. Oh, is that a wonderful drive? Superb squash. Any juniors watching this on the example of excellent drive play? Those are super glued to the wall. Oh, what a lob. This rally is a real advert for the women's game and the women's tour. Top quality squash. That's a great cross-court kill from Tran. She's taking a 4-2 lead. A little bit of words between them on court. Don't think, from what we've seen, that they're too happy with each other there.
4-2.
And that is a tactic that some of these players use. They full well know the score. They'll ask, try and break up the rally, waste a bit of time, annoy their opponent. They will not forget their score. This is their career, after all. They know exactly where they are in a game. They know exactly how much money is at stake. With a win or a loss, everything is tactical. Oh, that's a fantastic drive. She has a really strong backhand, Norton. And Tran is trying to take the ball. Oh, that's a great cross-court. Cross-court backhand.
3-5.
Volley kill. She's in control of the tee. She's really bringing the score back. Oh, she's unfortunate there. And Tran takes a 6-3 lead. And with an experienced player like Tran on court, she will be looking to capitalize on this. You can see she's unnecessary push when going for the let there. That's been given as a let. It's an unnecessary charge. I'm sure if that keeps happening, the marker will have a word. Let us know on the stream what you think. If you have any questions for the players at the end of the match. Oh, that is a great cross court. Sorry, backhand drop. That is an absolutely fantastic shot. Oh, there's no chance. You can see a lot of these players will build a rally. They'll drive the ball, build the rally, wait for the mistake from the opponent, and make the court absolutely massive with a drop shot just like that. Taking the ball early out of the air. Oh, that's a great shot. Catching her off guard. But both these women will try and push the other one to the back and take the ball early and go short. Make the court big. And both of these players are excellent at doing so. It's a great shot. Fist pump from Norton there. Just disguising the boast as a drive. Sending Turan the wrong way. You can hear the crowd. Really supporting Norton here. Oh, she could have played that. 5-7. But she's only got a let. Should have taken the opportunity to play that and get the kill. But Turan's got a game plan, and she'll stick to it. Oh, and she's forced the 10. Norton will be frustrated with that there. 8-5. It is looking like this game is heading to a deciding fifth game. It's a long day of squash here at the Granite Club. Some top quality stuff on display. Oh, that's a fantastic front court boast. 6-8. Really turning that into a weapon. Very difficult to pick up. She's asking for a let there.
It was too good. 9-6.
That's not been given as a let. Norton will be frustrated. But you can see her try and push that out of her mind. She'll want to end this now. Turan will look to capitalize. Great cross-court shot. Oh, and she's dug that out well. She'll go for the kill. Oh, that's a fantastic drive. Sends Turan the wrong way. You can hear the crowd really getting behind her. Fantastic squash on display. That's 9-7. 2 points is really nothing for these players. Oh, but that is a fantastic shot from Turan. Using all of her experience. And we'll see that this game will go most likely to 5. She's calling for a let there. It's been given as a let. Turan's not too pleased. Holly's doing everything she can to break up the game at the moment. I'm sure that was a tactical let. That's a great whip. Now it's 2-2. I'm watching a great game of squash here. Top quality squash, 2-2. It's difficult to say who's going to win this. You have the experience of Turan and the youth and exuberance of Norton. But we'll be back soon in about 2 minutes or so, bringing you the final game. And the winner will progress to the next round into the semis. And they will be playing Sam Cornett. So I'm sure she'll be watching very, very closely. I'm sure Sam Cornett would like to play in a fellow Canadian, like to see another Canadian doing well. But it may well be Samantha Turan, the more experienced of the two. And we'll be back in around a minute or so. Welcome back to the deciding game of the close encounter between Samantha Turan and Holly Norton in the quarterfinals of the 2015 Slate Music Granite Open. It's an exciting game of squash so far. It's very intense, very feisty on court between the Mexican Samantha Turan and the Canadian Holly Norton. Turan is in orange, Norton is in white. You're joining the action in the fifth game. Turan to serve. Oh, that's tight. It's a great kill, right into the nick. Lob. Strong early play from both these players. They both want to go to the next round. They will not let this one go. Oh, that's a great recovery boast. Oh, that's a fantastic drop from Turan. She's really looking comfortable in these early exchanges. She's using that extra experience. Keep herself calm. Keep sticking to her game plan. A little push there. The ref's got to do more to stop that. She's not really getting the height on the lob that she was in the second and third game. And that's allowing... Ooh. And that's allowing Turan into the court. Oh, and she's just clipped her. Ooh. And that's a painful one. But yep, Norton is struggling with her high cross-court lobs that she was using so well in the second and third game. And that's really closing the court, allowing Turan to keep control. It's not giving her enough time to recover and move onto the tee. That'll be something that she'll be aware of. And she'll be trying to sort out that width and height. Can be difficult. You're seeing this unique angle here. You can see the exchange of the players and how comfortable they are getting that rhythm. And one of them will look to change it up. And they see the opportunity. Oh, good exchange of drops. That's a great or unlucky pickup. I see that Turan has moved from... In the earlier games, she was trying to dictate the play down her forehand side. Bringing it cross court and trying to kill... on her backhand side, which is Norton's forehand, which she seems to have swapped and let Norton dictate the play on the left-hand side and go for those kills when the crosscourt comes in on her forehand. That seems to be working for her in the last two games so far. Oh, that's a great drop shot. Fantastic drop shot. She extends it to 5-1. Norton will be disappointed after working so hard to bring herself back into this. Shove there.
5-1.
But she's got the let. Oh, that's just out of court.
6-1.
And she extends the lead to 6-1. I'm sure Norton will be trying to keep herself calm. She can bring herself back into this game. saw yesterday in the game against the Torno. She was down for long sections of the game. And she is not happy about that tin there. She can see, keeping her breathing deep and heavy, trying to recover some composure. It can happen in squash. She'll be gutted to lose this after dragging it back. Neither of these players will give up. They do not get to the world rankings that they're at without having severe mental fortitude. But Turan is showing some class here. Oh, and she'll get a let there. Norton's complaining there. I think she does make a fair point. Turan is seeking these. She has a right to do so. She's got a right to seek that let. She can play the ball however she wants. She'll only get a let for it, but she does have a right to, and I think she can see that that's frustrating Norton. She's using that to her advantage. I think Turan has won the battle of tactics so far in this game. And that's a let, but that's unnecessarily aggressive from both players here. Perhaps a post-match interview from both of these might not be the best. We should probably do these separately. They may need to be separated to the opposite ends of the Granite Club. Luckily, it's a very big facility up here in Toronto. Little push there from Norton, getting her own back. Oh, a shove again from Turan. We don't like to see this. It's supposed to be playing squash. It's not supposed to be boxing. Oh, and Norton is struggling with this pressure, this hostile game. But Turan is exceeding, and you have to say, she is playing this one right. She's obviously identified that a bit of grit is needed. And she's coming out on top now. And you can sympathize with Norton. It is very difficult to play your own game when your opponent is getting close. Leaving one in on you, but within the rules, just. And Turan is playing a well-calculated game of squash here. She's 9-1 up in the final game. She's got the tactics nailed down to a T. And she has nailed herself to that T as well. In control of this game. Well in front of Norton here. That's a good nick. Great drop, great recovery play. And she's not giving this rally up. She's not giving this rally up. She does not want to let this go without a fight. It's a great drive. Oh, what a fantastic rally. You'll hear the crowd on your stream. Really spurring her on. Little glare there on the replay. She's saying, yep, I can win that too. Excellent player, Norton is. Ooh. Little eyebrow raise there from Norton. I'm sure many in the crowd have got raised eyebrows as well. Let's give it a let. Oh, what? In disbelief, rightly so, given as a no-let. Unnecessary call from Turan there. She's really been disrupting this game too much for my liking. Oh, a little shove there. We do not like to see that. Lynn Norton to come back into this. They feel she's being unfairly treated on court. Oh, but she's tinned that, and now Turan has match ball to send herself into the semis. And match up with Sam Cornett. And Turan and Sam have had some big matches in a patch in the past, so this could be another classic. Oh, she's really opened the court up there. Oh, she's going for a stroke. She won't get that. Not after the calls earlier in the day. I feel like could have been given a stroke, but with the attitude that this game's been played at,
she's bleeding.
I'm not sure she'll be given a stroke there. We're going to take a couple of minutes for a blood injury. And I think Holly will use this to her advantage. Take a couple of minutes break. Come back on court fresh. And try and overturn this 10-3 deficit. We'll be back in a minute or so. And we're back here, just taking a short blood injury break. You can see Holly with her coach. Just getting that footage to you. You can see Holly with her coach, just dressing that wound. And I'm sure she'll be using this break to get a bit of tactical advice. I'm sure she's been in this situation before. 10-3 down, and she'll know what to do. Words of wisdom from the coach, and she's just getting back up now. Getting back on her feet. She's got a band-aid on. Or for you UK viewers, she's got a plaster on. And I can just hear her saying that she was hit with a racket. Samantha Turan. She does not look happy. She looks fired up. I think she's really ready to take this game to Turan. She's got an uphill battle, but I don't think it's one she'll shy away from. Excellent game of squash. If you're just tuning in, we are a 2-2 up in a very, very feisty, aggressive game between two excellent players. And Samantha Taran is up 10-3 in a blood injury break. They're just warming up again, ready to go. And sometimes this little break can be very difficult to play with for the person in the lead. But this Taran is in orange, Samantha in white, and she's to serve. Taran will be looking to end this quickly, and she has done. And that is a victory for Samantha Taran in a very, very close fought, feisty match. And she wins 3-2. We're going to try and stay on air after that game. We're going to get the victor, Samantha Taran, to come and talk us through her strategy and how we went about that game. But that's a very close game, and I'm sure no one will be disappointed, but she can't be too disheartened with her performance. Excellent squash against a very experienced player. I've just been told that she's on her way over after that match. But it's a very close game. Recovering well in that game to bring it back, tie up the games, and finish in that in emphatic fashion, 11-3. And I'm just joined now. If we can get her a headset on. Here we go. Oh. So that was a very feisty, aggressive game. How did it feel on court in that kind of hostile atmosphere?
I played with Holly before. Then I knew it would be like that. She's improving a lot, but then I'm happy to win in 5.
Yep. And I mean, a couple of those lets and strokes didn't go your way. How difficult is that in a close game like this, when you know it's obviously very physically demanding, and when you have to replay a point that you feel you should have got on a stroke? How difficult is that mentally to?
I think it's part of the game, and you expect that it could be in your side or not. Then you just have to keep focus and thinking the next point, the next rally, the next shot, because I think it's in every sport, you know, it's not just in squash. Like, then you just have to do your own game and just keep focus.
It looked like in the final two games that Holly was struggling with her width on her cross court shots. Is that something you noticed and something you started picking off?
Yeah, I just trying to play basic, and she started doing some mistakes, and I was just focused, and yeah, I try to not cross court too much, and then just keep the basic game like good.
And I think a lot of people watching the stream will have noticed, and I noticed during commentary, you spend a lot of time on that tee, very high up on the court, and you move really well. What do you do in training to keep that intensity throughout? You can see a replay of the winning shot there,
yeah,
that Nick. What do you do in training to keep yourself pushing high on that, on the tee, and keeping that fitness throughout the entire game? Like, what is your go-to routines for that?
I don't know what to say, but I think just I do a lot of speed work, but recently it's been not easy times for me because I've been injured.
Yep.
Then you have to reduce that kind of training and just trying to do more basic things and more specific. Like on court, before I used to run outside, like in the track, and doing a lot of like plyometrics and these kind of things, but these days I need to reduce a little bit my training, and just on the match I need to try to volley, because once you are in the back, you are out of position, then you have to run more
and reset the rally and push forward and shot, and you did that wonderfully in that last two games and really regained control. Your next game in the semis, which will be at 7:45 tomorrow night, is against Sam Cornett.
Yeah.
Have you played Sam before on tour?
Yeah, we used to play a lot. She's a wonderful person, a wonderful player, and I'm so happy that she's back on tour after
that layoff with injury.
Yeah, we've been missing her, and it's so nice that we can play each other again.
So you're looking forward to the match tomorrow?
Yeah, of course.
You think it'll go to 5 or?
No, I don't even thinking about that. Like, I'm just step by step.
And we've been talking to a lot of the players when they come off, and they say, you know, even in those very hostile games, you know, where there's a little bit of pushing and shoving, a little bit left in there, but as soon as you come off court, that's almost forgotten, and you're friends again off court. Is that the case and with people on tour?
Yeah, like I think squash is kind of a small community, mm-hmm. and it's like everywhere you just on court is on court and outside, and you just have to be happy, and that's what most of the players we do, to enjoy also the tour, the traveling, the tournaments, the spectators, and
In conclusion, do you want to thank anybody that's watching at home? Or?
Yeah, of course, my parents, my coach, all my friends in Mexico, and all my sponsors, all the people who's been through all my career that always support me, and they know sometimes how tough could be this, and thanks for all the support. And if they are watching, I can speak a little bit in Spanish.
Yeah, go for it.
Si me están viendo, los quiero mucho y gracias por todo el apoyo. Y bueno, aquí estamos otra vez en la semifinal de un torneo más. Did you understand?
I have no idea what you said, but I'm sure it was very nice. So we'll be back broadcasting live here from the Granite Club tomorrow at 7 o'clock, and that's the first semi-final between Millie Tomlinson and Nadia Abbas, the 16-year-old Egyptian. That could be a very, very close game. Very exciting game of squash. And then you yourself will be playing Sam Cornette at 7:45. So that's it from us at the Slate Music Granite Open tonight. And we'll be back tomorrow.
And I also to see you then. Just want to thank Jessica and all the sponsors for this tournament.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
This is one of the best tournaments we play. We all the players enjoy being here, and it's fantastic that it's again this year, and also the family I stayed with. It's the second time I stayed with them, and I just want to thank them.
All right, some really nice words from there from Samantha Turan. And we're out from the Slate Music Open at the Granite Club Toronto, and we'll see you tomorrow night.